Hey there, Ben. So I understand that you're an adequate opposer of socialism. My question to you is about socialist ideas that have worked in the past, such as Social Security or Medicare. I understand Social Security is a mess right now, but it has helped millions of Americans in the past. So do you think that we should banish socialist ideas in general in the United States, or limit it to
banish
something like?
And the reason I say that is because so what socialism basically does is it takes the resources of a given society and it freezes them there and then it redistributes them. It doesn't account for growth, it doesn't allow for innovation and enlarging the pie. Socialism basically says, however much money is in the economy, it's unfair how it's distributed, take it, redistribute it, that's the end of it. The problem is once you do that, you get rid of the incentive to innovate and to build new things and create new services. So, of course it's true that if there are five of us in a room and I have $5 and nobody else has any money and I just give each person a dollar, then everybody in the room is better off except for me. That's true, but I now have no incentive to go out and make $5 more because you're all just going to take the money. This is true of Social Security also. So Social Security has actually created an enormous downside for society now. So in the short term, it's great, right? You take a bunch of money that doesn't belong to you, you give it to a bunch of old people, they're happy. It didn't cost you that much money because it's the baby boom and there are a lot of people who are young and there are not that many people who are old. Then the baby boomers get old and now we're all screwed, right? People who are our age are never going to see our Social Security money. It's gone. We're never seeing it again. Kiss it goodbye. Right, so one problem is that older people did not have an incentive to save. So the savings rate actually went down after Social Security because you may as well spend your money. Somebody else is going to pay for you when you're old. The second thing that happened is people stopped having kids as much. It actually had a marked impact. Jonathan V. Lass at Weekly Standard is a very good book about this. It actually had a marked impact on birth rates. Because one of the reasons to have a kid, not to be cynical about this, but it's true, is that historically, when you get old, who takes care of you? Your kids, right? I mean, that was the net cost. The net cost was that you were going to spend an enormous amount of money educating your children, bringing them up, keeping them safe, and then when you got old, you weren't going to have to worry about it because little Billy was going to take care of you. Now Social Security takes care of you, so do you even have to have kids? And that's what's created this enormous bulge in the old population in the United States and very little on the young side of the population in the United States. And because as a society, we tend to abdicate to government what government is willing to take over. It's also created this immoral notion that the government's going to take care of all the old people so we don't have to worry about it as a society. Social fabric doesn't matter anymore. So this is why I'm not in favor of socialism, you know, and Social Security is a good example. I'm not in favor of it because it has, just like every other socialist program, it has a set of discrete beneficiaries but diffuse victims. And the diffuse victims are much more common than the discrete beneficiaries, and they grow over time.